bit of coverage of the light rail line. Something new to Melbourne is the European style point direction indicators. The horizontal one at the top means that the device is in the process of changing its mind or otherwise failed. The other two show which direction your points are set. Well, the points are still some distance up from here, behind the truck and the bus up there, in fact. I'm not particularly impressed with some of the new point work in Melbourne. May not show up too good on the camera, but instead of using double groove or double rail bolted together form a groove, they're using a square section of steel billet, say about 5-inch square, with a groove cut in the top, and the stuff's just too soft and the tram wheels are chewing it to pieces. This is where the light rail comes in. In the middle of the screen there you can see where the flange has been chewing into the side of that. And it looks like the wheels have in places been up on top of the outer rail. Every time I look at it, it looks worse than the time before. And I'm surprised that something hasn't been through that fence yet. I thought it would have happened by February, but it still hasn't happened yet. They haven't been welding this up either. Thank you. St Kilda to the left, Port Melbourne to the right. Nothing much out on this line. It tends to be a bit of a white elephant. Not too many passengers, I'll count them. Yeah, crush load of about 20. I had as few as 4 last week on one trip at this time of day. All the old stations were bulldozed, so only rotting timber anyway. New stations are in the same location. Two level crossings on this line, one on the other line.